Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Come Holy Spirit, bless this unworthy priest, that I may preach with humility and with the heart, and that people listen with their hearts and not just with their lips, with their ears. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Sisters and brothers, Pentecost, the descent of the Holy Spirit, big feast in the church. We have the Holy Spirit. You know, the Holy Spirit is often the most neglected thou person of the Blessed Trinity. Kasi, you know, God the Father, Creator, God the Son, the Redeemer, Holy Spirit, parang. And yet, this is the age of the Holy Spirit. It's the time of the Holy Spirit now all over the world. Meron nga hong kwento ng isang bata. He was going to serve Mass, but then he was outside. He would not enter the sacristy. And the priest said, "Hey, Johnny, come. You have to start serving Mass. I cannot leave my bike. It might, baka mawala tong bike ko dito." And the priest said, "Don't worry. The Holy Spirit will guard your bike." Okay? So he came in. And when the boy started the prayer before the Mass, the boy said, "In the name of the Father and of the Son." And the priest said, "How about the Holy Spirit?" "Oh, he's outside watching my bike." Many times we forget the Holy Spirit. And, you know, you may have noticed that before homily, I always start with a simple prayer. Come, Holy Spirit, bless this unworthy priest. Alam po niyo bakit? Just to remind myself again and to really ask the Lord, Holy Spirit, to be with me. And you know where I got this? I got it from my mama. Many times, pag nag-uusap kami ni mama, yun, and when somebody says something, you know, something deep, something very touching, he would say, "Oh, Jerry, that's the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit yan." She made us aware that there's somebody who is with us, bigger than us. Mayroong Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. That's why I keep going back to that, if only to remind myself, hey, it's not me. Unless the Spirit speaks, everything is just here. Everything is just here. It's the Holy Spirit that touches and moves the heart. Let's always be aware that He is with us, always. And alam po nyo, I go back to my religious experience. I hope and I know marami sa inyo, you experience God in a very deep way. And for me, one of the highlights po, it happened in a charismatic renewal. In the 1970s, bago pa po yung charismatic movement, sa novitiate po kami, prayer meeting, there I experienced the presence of God. I was crying. I don't know why. Basta ramdam mo something warm, somebody was embracing you and loving you. For me, that was an experience of the Holy Spirit. At sana po, all of us, go back. Let the Spirit fill us up. Ay, many of us have dried up. Sabi nga ng isa, "Come, Holy Spirit, ang init. Come, Holy Spirit, sa may sakit. Come, Holy Spirit, sa mga nagagalit. Come, Holy Spirit, sa mga masungit." Ayan. Ganun po ang nangyayari kung walang Holy Spirit. Eh, parang everything goes nega-nega. Payagbangan, pasikatan, negativities. We need the Holy Spirit, especially now. And one more thing po, please don't forget, bago po natin makalimutan. The Holy Spirit descended upon the apostles and Mama Mary. She was there. She was with them. Siya rin madalas nakakalimutan natin. In fact, I believe in my heart. Remember, pagkatapos mamatay si Jesus, na-disband yung mga disciples. They were gone. They all ran away. Nagtago na. The dream is gone. It's finished. Let's go back to fishing. You know who started regrouping them? I believe it was the Blessed Mother who said, "Oy, Peter, come back. Halik kayo." The Mother brought them back together. Nag-regroup sila because of the presence of Mother Mary in their midst. That's why, very significant po, when the Holy Spirit descended, she was with them. On the birthday of the church, Mama Mary was there. So please, wag po natin deadmahin si Mama Mary. The Holy Spirit devotion and the Marian devotion are very strong in our founder, Saint Arnold Jensen, the SVD. So please don't forget our Lord's gift. It's a gift. You know, the Lord told us and the disciples, the first greeting was, "Peace be with you." You know why they needed to hear that? When they saw Jesus was alive, they were not scared na, "Oh, multo." No. They were so ashamed. Hiyang-hiya sila. They all betrayed him, ran away. They were filled with guilt. So the first thing Jesus did was, "Peace, okay na. Okay lang yan, don't worry. Okay na." Assurance right away. Because he was telling them already, you know, you come forward. Move out of your shell. Marami sa atin po, we're so caught in our depressions, our, "Hey, it's okay. Go forth. Lumabas ka na dyan." So that was the first thing the Lord told them. Speaking of going forth, you know, coming forward. Go forward. Mayroon pong kwento ng isang pare, tapos ng Sunday Mass, before the blessing, naalala niya mayroon siyang ikakasal the next Sunday. Pero nakalimutan niya yung, di ba, tinatawag, itatawag yung ikakasal, nawala yung listahan. Sabi niya, "Lord, Holy Spirit, tulungan mo ako." And then he said, sino yung gustong magpakasal after the Mass, you come here, huh? Come to me. Okay. Guess what? After the Mass, the couple arrived and 10 old maid. Lumapit din. Yung gusto magpakasal, kaya nagdatingan na. You see the surprise, how the Holy Spirit can operate. So mga kapatid, this is it. Go forth. Come out. Come and go forward. Siguro ito po ang sinasabi ni Lord sa atin. Come and be at peace. Okay na. Leave your comfort zones. Leave your darkness behind. You have to come to the light. Don't stay in the darkness. That's what the greeting was all about. Peace be with you. And the second greeting was, you have ambition. Let's read that. Peace be with you. And he said to them, as the Father has sent me, so I send you. Ah, mission na ang pinag-uusapan. Sige na, tama na yung mga kung ano mo. Leave that and go forward. And now do your mission. So ang dasal po natin unang-una, especially yung mga hindi makamove on, palagi kang nandyan sa sarili mo, you cannot go forward. You know why? Because your mindset. So the best prayer is, Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit, reset my mindset. yan ang openness. Pag mindset mo negative, hanggang dito ka lang, you cannot be open to the Holy Spirit. Number two, to do your mission, it will involve sacrifice, hard work. Ang hirap po. So what is our prayer? Constant prayer, come Holy Spirit, enkindle the fire of your love in my heart. Lord, pag-alabin mo palagi po ang puso ko ng pagmamahal mo. Kasi we get tired. We get bored. We get exhausted. So come Holy Spirit, pagod na po ako. Help me to love some more. Help me to love some more. This is what it means, do your mission. And finally, what is the assurance, the third message? You are not alone. The Holy Spirit will go with you. Receive the Holy Spirit. Any disciple going or doing a mission has the Holy Spirit. Kaya lang madalas nakakalimutan natin siya. Parang yung bike, iniwan mo doon. Nagbabantay lang ang Holy Spirit. Is not with you. So our prayer should always be, Lord, please, always be with me. The indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Yun po palagi mga dasal natin, mga kapatid, ha? Because, you know, kung hindi po tayo wala yung Holy Spirit sa isang tao, we really don't bear fruits. Ang dami po dyan. Well, even those who claim to be disciples, ang daming achievements. Siguro, ang daming mga plaque, ang daming mga functions. Pero parang walang fruit. You know why? It's all about them. Going back to Mama, my Mama did not study, did not know theology, but she had a deep spirituality. Yun po, because of the Holy Spirit. Ang dami naman dyan, ang galing sa theology, may mga doctorate pa, etc. Pero wala namang masyadong spirituality. What does it mean? You have to go back to the fruits of the Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit is not just the functions we do, the great things we achieve. No, it's about you, me. Is the Spirit evident in my life? Kasi daming nagawa dyan, pero tignan mo siya, ba't ang tapang, ang sungit, ang yabang? Mother Angelica says like, the most important and the most evident presence of the Holy Spirit is in the person. Not so much in the works that the person does. Please, let's go back to that. Otherwise, kung ganun lang usapan, di, hindi tayo missionary, mercenary lang. Di ba? Just do the job. Doesn't matter who I am. Hindi ho eh. Iba hong operation ng simbahan eh. Or I can finish everything. I can, and I'm detached. Hindi po. You have to be attached. That's the presence of the Holy Spirit. Check this, please. Do you have the fruits of the Spirit? This is something we always say. Sa dami na mga ginagawa natin, sinasabi natin, pero teka muna. First fruit of the Spirit is charity. Do I have charity? Oh, second fruit of the Spirit, joy. Are you joyful? Father, dapat ganito, matapang lang tayo, wala mga joy-joy. No, we need to be witnesses. Peace. Do you have peace? Then the Holy Spirit is with you. Peaceful ka ba? Patience. Naku, yun na. Kindness. Are you kind to people? goodness. Katulong ka. Kind words. Encouragement. Generosity. Simple lang po yung magbigay. Not only things. Give your time. Give your talent. Waste time with people. Gentleness. In thought, in word, and in deed. Faithfulness. Modesty. Self-control. Chastity. Galatians chapter 5, 22 to 23. It's sigurong paalala ng Holy Spirit sa atin. Fine, your works are good. Your intelligence is fine. Your eloquence is fine. But it has to be you. So let's all pray for that fruit of the Spirit in our lives, in our persons. And this is where humility comes in. When you realize, hey, this life is not about me. It's about this God. This about this God who wants to show love to all people in spite of me. Oh, another thing I think we should start asking is, ang ganda po eh, symptomatic. Kung ang Holy Spirit na sa iyo, may symptoms ka. May iba namang walang symptom. Okay. For example, symptoms of inner peace. Paki-check nga po. Frequent attacks of smiling. Mayamayang umingiti-ngiti ka na lang. Ano nangyari? Basta lang. Oh, that's a good symptom. Episodes of appreciation. Oy, oy, thank you, ha? Mayamaya kung sino-sino na lang. Manong, salamat, ha? You're grateful to people. Marunong ka magpasalamat. Loss of interest in judging others or comparing yourself with others. Wala na yan. May iba sa COVID, loss of smell, no? Loss of taste, wala na. Sa atin, wag na. Don't judge people, okay lang. And some people who are just comparing themselves always with others. Sometimes you go to this mga thread ba ng how people nagtatagisan ng mga, wow, no? Hindi yan Holy Spirit. Evil spirit na yan. Yan ang gusto ng evil spirit. Payabangan, pasikatan, pabunggahan. O, isa pa. You're worry-free. Hindi ka na nag-worry masyado kung ano-ano. And there are people who keep worrying and worrying. Walang katapusan. And they broadcast their worries to everyone to know or to sympathize with them. Hindi na po. Okay na yan. Nandiyan naman si Lord. One symptom also, you become more hopeful and less fearful. Pag-asa lang, diba? Hope lang. Continue to hope. O ninyo, kailan ang birthday mo ninyo? Birthday mo?
February.
February 2, Candelaria. Pray natin sa birthday mo, wala na yung COVID. Diba? Ayos lang. Hope instead of fear. Why keep talking about fear when it's hope that people need? Another symptom is you enjoy simple moments. Ah, okay, nice. Oh, okay lang. Oh, maglakad-lakad ka, makita mo yung mga... To see an airplane, to see the birds, etc. Okay. Oh, another symptom is you become more giving and more loving, even if you have problems. Thank you, sa mga generous people. I am so overwhelmed. Maya-maya may nagpadala ng pagkain, nagpadala ng mga bulaklak, may nagpadala ng mga antigen, ganun. God, Lord, thank you. These are generous people. They have problems. Symptomatic sila of the Holy Spirit. Wanting to be alone in prayer. Yun, symptom yan. Lord, yung dito lang ako, yung mag-isa lang, to be hidden, to be alone, beautiful. Symptom yan, that the Holy Spirit is with you. Finding peace in humility and hiddenness. When you can say, okay lang, Lord, sige na, tapos nakangiti ka pa. Pag nakita ka ng mga tao, sira na yata itong tao ito. Or, well, if the symptoms persist, you have the Holy Spirit. Siguro yun po ang ating kwang ngayon. You know why it's so important? Because the Holy Spirit can give true peace and joy at this time when gulong-gulo na po talaga. Ang dami na pong nadidepress. So, let the Holy Spirit fill us that we can overflow. Come forward, do your mission. The Holy Spirit is with you. So, sisters and brothers, I remember one last story. Sa heaven daw, final judgment. Nandiyan na lahat. Naghihintay. Abi daw, announcement. Those who did not violate the first commandment, one step forward. Oh, one step lahat. Dami. Those who did not violate the second commandment, one step forward. Daming step forward. Mga iba, medyo naiiwan. Everybody stepping forward. Pagdating ng sixth commandment, those who did not violate the sixth commandment, you know, about sex and all that, one step forward. Ganunan sila lahat. Walang naka-forward. Tapos may isang matanda na monk, dahan-dahan, mag-isa lang siya. Umabante. Siya lang talagang nag-qualify. Yang-yapa nga siya kasi wala nang kasama. Sabi raw ni St. Peter, Boss, malaking problema to. Mukhang wala nang makakapasok. Ito lang makakapasok sa langit. So nag-meeting daw ang Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. After the meeting, na-announce na, with the love of the Father, Son, the Spirit, we hereby declare general amnesty. Everybody in. Wow! Talaga, nagtakbuhan na lahat. Talagang ang saya nila. That's it. Pentecost is general amnesty for all of us. All in. Okay na. Just peace be with you. Do your mission and the Holy Spirit will be with you. Let's not focus on our negativities. Even our failures are nothing compared to God's love and forgiveness. Kaya lang, the sequel to that story, may mga ayaw pumasok. May isang grupo doon, no? Hindi na kami papasok, kayo na lang. Bakit? Sabi raw ni St. Peter, minitin siya lang. Pambira naman. Kami, nagsikap kami hanggang fifth commandment, nakaabot kami. Sobra naman yan, general amnesty lang pala. Nagtiis kami, nagsakripisyo na't lahat. Bakit nag-general amnesty? Question nila the generosity of God. And according to this story, that group that questioned God's generosity, they were forever barred from heaven. You know why? They were still selfish. They were still so centered on themselves. This is what it means. Pentecost is just reaching out as God so loved the world. Lahat po tayo, let's continue to share this love and to be generous, especially to bear fruit, the fruits of the Holy Spirit in our lives. So our prayer is, come Holy Spirit, we need you to live well. Otherwise, without you, we just live. Come Holy Spirit, we need you to love much. Otherwise, without you, we just love ourselves. And Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit, we need you so we can laugh often. Without you, we're just end up burdened. Come Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit. And Mama Mary, thank you so much. Immaculate Spouse of the Holy Spirit, filled with the Holy Spirit, pray for us, dear Mother and model. Amen. And today, on the birthday of Mother Church, we pray that the church will be more open and docile, especially with this pandemic and post-pandemic, to be more open to new ways of thinking and new ways of doing mission according to the heart of the Master, according to what Jesus really wants us to be. May we be a church that Jesus will still recognize as the church He founded. Let's go back, keep going back to the source. Yes, and let the Holy Spirit lead us. Amen and amen.